Heading to Russia, and for a number of months, journalists and politicians critical of the Kremlin have been targeted. And on the first day of parliamentary elections, tech giants Google and Apple bowed to pressure and removed an app launched by supporters of the jailed activist Alexei Navalny.
The banner reads, "Freedom to Navalny, Putin to prison," up for 10 seconds before the police close in. It's brave on Red Square right in front of the Kremlin. Because ahead of parliamentary elections this weekend, the Kremlin has waged an unprecedented crackdown. It started with the poisoning of opposition leader Alexei Navalny last August. Now he's in jail and nearly all his top team have fled Russia. And it's not just the opposition, it's the independent media too, like Dozhd or Rain TV, recently labelled a foreign agent, which means laborious audits and this lengthy disclaimer on every post and article declaring you an enemy of the state.
What do you think that the Kremlin is up to? Because this year and the last few months have really seen an escalation.
I think for a long time, Russian authorities, they were pretending that we have a democracy here. But one day they decided not to pretend anymore.
In Moscow, at a rain-soaked meeting with journalists, parliamentary candidates promise they'll fight to repeal the foreign agent law.
No one here thinks that the pressure on journalists is going to let up. No one here thinks that the pressure on any kind of opposition is going to let up now that Navalny has been jailed and his associates essentially run out of the country. This feels like a small, forlorn little gathering at a really sad moment for civil society in Russia.
Even the established opposition parties, generally more token than anything else, are getting whacked. We're at the Lenin State Farm just outside Moscow. The boss here, Pavel Grudinin, was barred from running for parliament for the Communist Party. He ran for president against Vladimir Putin in 2018, winning just 12% of the vote, but enough to rile powerful forces.
Кандидат президента, который набрал второе место, получил достаточно много голосов, он всегда опасен для тех, которые планируют получить власть после ухода предыдущего руководителя. У депутатов есть такая вещь, как трибуна, есть узнаваемость. Вот. А кому-то хочется, чтобы о мне просто забыли.
Forgotten and bankrupt, Grudinin says he's faced lawsuits at every corner. But barring popular candidates like him runs the risk of turning the Communist Party into an actual political force. And ratings for the ruling United Russia Party are the worst they've ever been. President Putin is weirdly nervous about these elections. These Soviet-style repressions, a way of destroying anything that might chip away at the edifice of power.